You see, the problem with Kubo, and again, I've been doing this job as a Bleach YouTuber for years. Absolutely. I mean, depressing as it is, 10 years. I know Kubo. I know when he's waffling. I know when he's teasing. And this is, it's getting out of hand, Kubo. Let's just put the line in the sand and just say it. You know? Just talk about the hell arc, because the cock is being teased. So if you want to know what I'm talking about, of course, you gotta stick around for this video. Hit that like and subscribe if you like this type of content. Let's get into this weird and interesting type of news, shall we? Are you tired of those very big companies that license your favorite series and decide to drop merch with just a copy-pasted manga panel? Well, so is the Bleach community. Because my friend and fellow YouTuber DBZ Imran has dropped Getsuga.com. Getsuga is a clothing brand specifically tied to you, the fans, and the Bleach aesthetic, that rather than just copy-pasting a manga panel, has in fact blended and perfected the amount of Kubo titles, poetry, and manga imagery. Currently, the website is promoting its Undead collection with just over 20 days to get, with two of my favorite designs personally being the Undead, with that really cool slash effect right through the text, and the best, in my opinion, the Blade of Fate. Each of these designs have their own relevance towards its respective chapter and the character that it's resembling. These designs and material hold quality, as well as community feedback, so please, show your love, because I really need that Ruruka collection, guys. Check out Getsuga in the description down below, and let's get right into the video. So if you guys haven't been made aware, obviously we've made videos talking about the Bleach Hell arc in the past. Many times, in fact, we've gone and talked about the way the story can go, about theories about the Hell arc, how Kubo does a one-shot, and usually a one-shot concludes. Kubo's like, oh yeah, let me do a one-shot, and let me just end it on a cliffhanger for absolutely no reason. Creates, you know, the original Gotei 13 with names and backgrounds that we won't apparently see in quotations. And then the last video that I did, I talked about the Bleach exhibit, about how popular the Hell arc was, and just how, please go watch that video, just the amount of people that was in that area at that one space was just baffling to me, to say the least. And then to then talk about how these three random seated officers that were part of Izuru's squad 3 are going to get like their Zanpakuto abilities explained at some point in the future. Now again, a data book, sure, I'm all down for a data book, but it gets to a point where you have to read between the lines, and the lines are being presented so much that pretty much handheld to you, right? So what's the latest and greatest update? Well, again, we have to go back to, of course, our Q&A of Club Outside, the website where Kubo answers all of the fans' questions, and then we'll talk about it, shall we? And also, before I do that, I'm pretty sure that there was an answer about something where it was quite relevant, so the fact that I can't remember is annoying me. But there was a question about some character doing something, and then Kubo was like, oh, I'd like to draw it at some point. And it's like, okay, where are you gonna draw it? Right? And it's not in relation to this, and I'll talk about why that's relevant in a minute, because I'm gonna start waffling now. But the question is, how did Yamamoto, Gemru Yusai, and Yachiru Unohana meet up? And Kubo responds with, I might draw it someday, so it's a secret. Now, I'm sorry, I don't know about you guys. Now, I've got quite a few of the Bleach data books. Of course, sometimes you'll get like a little backstory about Okiura. You know, we had that. We had a little bit of a backstory in 13 Blades about Shuhei Isage. Cool. But the amount of things that Kubo apparently wants to showcase to us in drawing it someday has got to the point where even if it is a data book, theoretically, it would pretty much be a new manga at this point. So, yeah. Okay, cool. Where is this material gonna come from? Is it gonna be new anime content? I mean, is Yachiru Unohana and Gemru Yusai going to be shown in the anime? Do you know what? It could be a shout. It could be a shout. Core 4 maybe. Not in Core 4. I don't know. It's quite possible. It's quite possible. But we have to kind of go things on what's the most realistic approach. And considering I've read, you know, the Thousand Year Blood War, I don't see then again, they've got like a whole core of almost like 80% of original content, so fuck if I know. But with the amount of things he wants to showcase to us, the amount of things that he's secretly drawing or he wants to draw at some point, you know, not everything's... Even if Yachiru Inahana and Yamamoto Genma Yusai meeting is going to be shown in the Thousand Year Blue Ball arc, it doesn't take away or attest for the other stuff that Kubo said he wants to draw and show to us anyway. So, or has already done. So the question is like, you can look at multiple different factors, which is Hell arc or even a movie. Okay, some of this stuff might be filler for Thousand Year Blood War arc, but the fact of the matter goes, and I've said this abundantly a million times, I mean, look at the Bleach website in general when we talked about the domains, when Bleach was first getting announced for the Thousand Year Blood War arc. We found out that there was a domain for the Thousand Year Blood War. Well, I'll be more specific, for the Bleach anime IP as a whole. And that was a 10-year domain registry. 10 years. I mean, look at Core 4, that's 4 to 5 years, right? Like Core 1, Core 2, Core 3, and Core 4, that's going to be like 4 years to 5 years. What are we going to do with the other 5 years, right? Is it just going to sit there dormant? No, you don't pay for that long. I mean, look at Burn the Witch, for example. It only had 2, and then it got renewed for another year, and then boom, 0.8 came out. So you can take, you know, some business logical approaches when it comes to domains, right? There's a lot of businessy things you can kind of make some genuinely very good predictions. But with Bleach, this is long term, and I've always said it's been long term, even past Thousand Year Blood War. Bleach has been so successful. You have to understand that TV Tokyo, it has changed the way of how they do anime now, where they're making everything seasonal. They saw the success through Bleach. I'm not even saying this. This is the CEO that's saying this. This is the IP licensor that's saying this. These people are saying Bleach is doing successful. This is the rebirth of Puro. And you're telling me the production company is going to be like, yeah, it's after Thousand Year Blood War, it's done. Yeah, it's fine. That's Kubo's story is over. No. No. And Kubo, yet again, keeps teasing these things that he wants to draw or is keeping secret. Keeping secret for what? What are we keeping secret? You only keep things secret when you're going to announce it or show it publicly in the future. And the fact that you outright said you're going to draw it goes to show to me, we're going to get Hell Arc. So the question is, I need people to stop asking when is the Bleach Hell Arc. I think everyone knows how popular that is. It's one of the most requested things in Bleach right now, to the point where Kubo said, please stop asking me about it. The author's literally saying, please, just let me cook. Let me cook in peace, right? Otherwise, you're going to annoy me and I'm just not going to do it. He's been asked. He knows it's popular. He knows that people want it. Shueisha knows that people want it. But we have so many things to get through first. We need to get through the storyboardings of Core 4. Core 3 is pretty much done in terms of pre-production. So, you know, he's got involved with Core 3. He's getting involved with Core 4, naturally. We don't even know about, you know, the marriage of Rukia and Renji. We don't know about Khan for Your Own World yet. These are things that we've got to dabble into first before we even get into the Hell Arc. We have Season 2 of Burn the Witch. Kubo is meticulously prioritizing things in a certain order. And that's how he's going to do it. So the longer Hell Arc takes to make, the more thought and the more planning, the more stress-free environment that Kubo works under, let him cook. But if there is any more reinforcement that this is a shout-out to how Yuha, Yamamoto and Yachiru Inahana met, then even more better. Do you know what that says? Do you know what that fucking says? The fact that Yamamoto and Inahana meet? You know what that says? The thing that I've been saying for absolutely since this original Gotei 13 was shown, is that they are going to get a backstory. You don't make these many characters, you don't make the foundations of this Gotei 13 and not give them elaboration. So you're telling me Kubo's going to draw Genma Yusai and Yachiru Inahana meet up and not show any of the other original squad, I can't even say it. The 13 court guards. You're absolutely on crack if you don't believe that. So, you know, that's my thoughts on it. I think it's going to be amazing. How do I think it happened? I think You know, I think probably Yamamoto with some of the other guys. Chika's got to be in there. I reckon he's literal, like, royalty. So he's definitely got to be in there along with... Because he's a Shihoin, right? So he's got to be royalty, obviously. So he's definitely probably the original with Genri Yusai. And I'm going to give a shout to... It's got to be Furufushi. I need Furufushi. Furufushi, she gives me royalty vibes. I don't know what, but Furufushi, I feel like she's like a main. She's got to be a main. You don't put that girl, that Ruruka-looking princess goddess, at the front of the color page. Front, where everybody can see it, and not make her, like, one of the main of the 13. You just don't do it. You just don't. So I do think, you know, I think it started off as a trio. I think Yamamoto's running around the streets of the Rokungai, whatever the fuck you want to call it, and stumbled upon Yachiru and Ahana, and was like, yeah, let's have a little fight. They had a little fight, they had a little skirmish, and he was like, I like you, you're joining my team. Like, I own you now. And because, look, Yachiru is a killer. Nobody controls a killer unless you're stronger than that person. And I think Yamamoto was the one to tame her. So, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below, what you think Hell Arc is coming. Don't ask when, but more so... Well, I mean, you can ask when, sure, but it's coming. So just get excited. Bleach has a future. That's something we all want. I'm in the job for a little more. But anyway, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Ben Hansen. And of course, in the link in the description, go check out that nice, spicy little website too. Peace out, and as always, people, I didn't really have an outro, but have a nice day.